Next business, the next one is Deputy Morris Quinlivan to the Minister for Justice to discuss the prevalence of drugs in Limerick City. Deputy, it's 4 minutes.
Well, Scar Margaret Cahirlach, Minister, can I just congratulate you on your appointment? I haven't interacted with you in this new doll as of yet. Minister, I know you're relatively new to the new role, so I hope you'll have a better impact than those that preceded you on dealing with the issue of drugs in my city, and it truly does need a cross-departmental response. Drugs, are you aware, across several ministries, health, justice, to name a few. The drugs crisis in parts of my own city is worsening on what seems like a daily basis. It's an indictment of the priorities of previous governments that the funding for drug and alcohol task forces was cut each year between 2008 and 2014. I'm also director of the Midwest Region Drug and Alcohol Forum, of which I've been a member for a huge number of years. Despite the escalation of the drugs crisis, funding for many groups has effectively been frozen since 2014. This lack of proper funding has severely affected the delivery of services for communities, and we need to restore that funding to 2008 levels as soon as possible. Now, Minister, I want to return to an issue in my home city of Limerick. In recent drug seizures in the city, crack cocaine was amongst the drugs seized. Crack cocaine, as I'm sure you're aware, is a devastating drug. It has destroyed communities across the world. It is extremely addictive and is regarded as the most addictive form of cocaine. There really is a special place in hell for anyone who sells, distributes or benefits from the sale of crack cocaine. These dealers really are the scum of the earth. Yesterday, the Minister attended the AGM via Zoom of the Midwest Region Drug and Alcohol Forum. Amongst the issues of concern raised, I was specifically asked to raise the issue of drug dealing in Limerick and the devastating effect it is having on some of our local communities. After that meeting, I wrote to Minister Fehan, as the Minister for State of the Department of Health with responsibility for the National Drug Strategy yesterday. And in fairness, his office responded quickly to that, so I want to thank him for that, and I will be following up with him. I mentioned to him in particular Limerick Estate. While he said, I don't want to name the other estate publicly, it needs urgent intervention from Minister Fehan, with support from your Department of Justice, from a Garda Síochána, with additional resources from the Criminal Assets Bureau, with Limerick Council and other agencies who need to intervene as a matter of urgency. I wish to focus my comments tonight on that one estate in Limerick. This is an older, very settled housing estate with lots of wonderful working families living there for generations. Unfortunately, drug dealing operates there on an almost 24/7 basis. Taxis often form queues while people from all over the region purchase their drugs. Many people simply walk into the estate. It's like a non-stop 24/7 supermarket. The vast bulk of these people getting the drugs don't live in the area. Minister, this is ongoing 24/7, non-stop. Many elderly people who work all their lives are living through this constant criminality. Whilst the Gardaí, in fairness to them, have made significant arrests and seizures, the local community feels utterly, utterly abandoned. Could the Minister prioritise the working, especially of the courts, to ensure those facing charges are brought before the courts as soon as possible? It has been said to me on numerous occasions that the most vulnerable can be brought to court for often very minor offences, but the drug dealers, many of them facing senior charges, can swan around our city selling their filth while ruining lives in communities. And I've been spoken to senior Gardaí about this. They're deeply concerned that they're charging people, they're bringing them to court, and because the courts aren't sitting properly, they are out selling 24/7. The local drugs gang gives two fingers to everybody on a regular basis. The Defence Forces were redeployed recently to assist the Criminal Assets Bureau, and Defence Forces should be called on again, if necessary, to deal with this ongoing problem. The two fingers from these drugs gangs are not just to me, nor to the local community, nor to Garda Síochána or Limerick Council. They're two fingers to you, Minister, but clearly they're definitely two fingers to the whole state. So you are the Minister for Justice, and I'm asking you to personally intervene. And I'm happy to speak with you later in private if you want at another time.
Thank you, Deputy.
Thank you, Deputy.